Have you ever grabbed a loaf of bread, made a sandwich, and then discovered that the bread was all moldy? It smells bad and it looks disgusting, so it's natural to wonder if there are any ill health effects that come from accidentally eating it. Mold is made up of tiny fungi that can show up on just about any foodstuff, such as the fresh fruits and vegetables you forgot about, that package of lunch meat you found in the back of your fridge, or your leftovers from 2 weeks ago. Some mold is obvious and apparent, but according to the US Department of Agriculture, it doesn't always show up on the surface. And it's not always the blue-green color you're accustomed to. Mold can be quite small, and it can also look like some harmless white fuzz on your food. It's still mold, though, and there's likely to be even more mold rooted deep inside your meal that you don't always see until it's too late. So, say you've eaten half of your hot dog and that last bite of the bun was moldy. Of course, you stop eating it and spit out what's left, but what really happens when you ingest the disgusting fungus? The good news is that it's usually immediately apparent that you've taken a bite of something bad, so you stop eating it ASAP. Ingesting a small amount of mold isn't likely to cause you any harm. However, mold itself can trigger an allergic reaction in those who are susceptible, and certain molds produce poisonous substances that can make you sick. If the mold isn't putting off toxins, you'll probably just have a bad taste in your mouth. When you eat a bite of toxic mold, though, effects can vary. Symptoms can range from loss of appetite and loss of energy to a serious illness. In rare cases, ingesting toxic mold can be fatal. If your food is moldy, wrap it in a plastic bag and throw that nastiness away. Resist the urge to sniff it, because that can cause breathing issues. Oh. Clean the area where you found your moldy food thoroughly. And if you experience any symptoms, even mild ones, it's a good idea to get checked out. The USDA does have a handy list, though, that outlines whether or not you can simply chop off the affected part and safely consume the rest of the food, instead of wasting what looks like perfectly good bread. Here's a breakdown of what you need to completely discard, and when you can simply chop off the moldy part, and how much to cut away. Firm fruits and vegetables like cabbage, bell peppers, and carrots can be preserved if you find the mold. Their dense structure means that mold has a hard time penetrating further into the food. Cut at least 1 inch around and below the mold spot, and don't pull your knife through the mold as it can contaminate everything else. Hard cheese can also be preserved if you find mold. For hard cheese where mold is not part of the manufacturing process, meaning you found a spot of mold randomly on your cheese, you can safely cut it off, again with at least a 1 inch margin between the mold and the rest of the food. But only on hard cheese. Hard salami and dry cured country hams can also be used if mold is present. It's common for these products to even have surface mold when purchased. Just scrub the mold off the surface and it's fine. For everything else, including that entire loaf of bread you just bought without noticing the mold, you have to throw the whole thing away. Mold can spread through porous foods such as bread and foods with high moisture content, such as soft fruits and veggies, which can be contaminated below the surface. If you're not sure though, just chuck it in the bin, because when it comes to mold, the old adage, when in doubt, throw it out, is sound advice. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more Mashed videos about food safety are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.